Okay student, today we will discuss how to transform ER diagram into relation using Lucidchart, that is also called logical database design. Whenever we are having the ER diagram, we have to transform ER diagram into relation, and then we have to create the different type of relation based on the logical database design in any DBMS like Oracle, MySQL, SQL Server or any others. So we have the different set of the rules are there. Very first one, we have mapping regular entity to relations. Whenever we are having the different entity types are there, each and every regular entity types we have to transform it into the relation. So the name of entity type is generally assigned to the relation. So whenever we have any entity type is there, the name of that entity type will be the name of the relation. So let we see that we are having the entity type is available over here. This one is very simple entity type. The name of entity type is customer. So when we have to create the relation, the name of relation will be customer. As what we see, the name of regular entity type will be the name of the relation. So our relation or table name will be customer. Then simple and single value attribute, all of these are the simple attribute and single value attribute. No one attribute is a multi-valued, mean on the intersection of each row and column there is the atomic value. No multi-value attribute is here, so that's why that is a single value attribute. And simple attribute, we are not decomposing any attribute into meaningful component, that's why we say that is a simple attribute. So what is the rule? Simple and single value attribute of entity type become the attribute of the relation. How we can transform it into the relation? We have to open the Lucidchart. How we can start it, like Google it. If you don't have the account in Lucidchart, then you can create the account in Lucidchart, search it over here, and you can sign up account in Lucidchart. So I already have the account in Lucidchart. That is very simple. You can simply create it account in Lucidchart. So I already have. So that's why it say that you can sign up freely. So I already have. I am just clicking to over here log out and then log in with the new account or already existing account. Click over here on login. So it will ask for the account, enter the address. So I'm using the Gmail account or Google account to log in with the Lucid. Now it's my dashboard over here. Now I can create the new documents over here, or I already have the blank documents. Clicked over here, new. Now it's that Lucidchart and blank documents. Clicked over here on blank documents. So blank documents over here. Now I'm creating create documents anyway. As this one is we can freely use it, or we have to upgrade it into the premium versions. So we have to create the logical database design for the given entity type. So what we have to do here, whenever we have to transform the ER diagrams into relation, so we need the concept of the relation and the graphical representation method. We have to search it over and shape the concept of the table. When we search the table, the different type of the tables are given. So let me search it over here. I am searching it over here though. Like we say, it say that smart table is here. Just drag and drop it. Oh no. Load more icon. Now here we have a and tables. We have a table is available. Drag this and drop it over here. When we drag and drop, so we have our table over here on the blank documents. We can change this one blank documents name, let logical database. I'm using the name it over here, logical database design. So this one is here. Now when we select it over here, it will display the number of column and number of rows. So as we see that we need the number of the columns are there, but we need it over here only one row in a logical database design. So number of rows, decrease it over here and we use it over here 1. Now we have a number of rows 1 and number of columns are here 3. We can extend it just this one, or we can decompose like this one. So what we want, we can do it over here. Now we can increase the size of any columns, or we can decrease the column size of any columns as per our requirement. Now very first things, what was the rule? That we see that the name of regular entry type become the name of relation. So here our entry type name is customer, so our relation name must be customer. So how we can use it over here? To assign the name it over here, we have to click it over here on insert, and insert we have the document's name. Click over here on the document's name, drag it and drop it over here. So what should be the name of this one table? We see that this one table name should be customer. Now table name is here customer. Now what should be the attribute over here? We see that simple and single value attribute of the relation become the attribute, simple and single value attribute of entry type become the attribute of relation. So here we say that simple attribute is here customer ID, customer name and date of birth. All of these are the simple as well as single attribute. These attribute become the attribute of the relation. So we have to move to the Lucid chart. Here first one we have the customer ID. We can see that it is also expanding. Now if we see that is not enough space for this one, so just drag it. We can increase or decrease the space of this one. Now next one is our customer name. And now still enough space is there, so I am using this one. And last one column that we need it over here, that is a customer date of birth. So use that one in the Lucid chart. Relation customer. Now if we want to expand now this one, customer date of birth. All of these simple and single value attribute of the relation become of the entry type become the attribute of the relation. Now next step is we have the identifier of entry type. Last one we said it, identifier of the entry type become the primary key of the corresponding relation. So the identifier of the entry type, here we have the customer ID, it become the attribute of the relation. So how we can assign it over here? Just we have to, for the primary key, just select it over here. Customer ID is the primary key, so select customer ID, and here we have the underline, or simply we can use it over here, control U. So it will be the primary key. If we don't have the concept of that one, then we can go for the control U to underline the customers, or if any option is not available, we can use it over here PK with the primary key attribute. Now this one is just for the first one rule, that the name of the entry type become the name of relation, simple and single value attribute of the entry type become the attribute of the relation. Now if we have the composite attribute, like taking the example in the same entry type, then what will be happened? Like here we have the customer ID, simple attribute, single value attribute, customer name, simple and single value, customer date of birth, simple and single value attribute, postal code, that is also a simple and single value attribute. But we see that customer address is a composite attribute that can be decomposed into meaningful component like street, city and state. Although we can decompose customer name, first name and last name, but we didn't decompose it over here. It depends on us that which one attribute that we are considering as a composite attribute. So here we consider that customer address is a composite attribute, while customer name we say that is a simple attribute. Now customer address is a composite attribute having the attribute street, city and state. So how we can transform it? The rule for the composite attribute, simple and meaningful component of the composite attribute become the attribute of the relation. So instead of mention customer address as a name of relation, we have to write it over a simple and meaningful component of composite attribute. And so these components are street, city and state. So simple and meaningful component of the composite attribute become the attribute of the relation. So for composite attribute we say that simple and meaningful composite attribute, simple component of attribute of the composite include in the new relation. So how we can do it? Now here we have the street, city and next one straight. So how we can now click over here, click on the relation, it will display the number of the columns. Now increase the number of the columns. We need the number of the columns, three more columns. So three already available. So next we have the total number of the column will be 6. So we say that street, then we say that city. Now next one state. Now if we see it over here, for the street columns we have enough spaces there, so we can reduce it over here, just select it over here, drag it. Again city, we have enough spaces there. Now if we want to reduce this straight, we can reduce it over here, right? Now what we have to do now, next we see that we have another column. If we see that if any column don't have enough space, so now we see that few columns don't have enough space, so we can select it, now that is the way in which we have to transform it. Now we have another attribute, that was postal code. So we have to add, that is a simple and single value attribute, so add this one attribute in the relation as it is. So again we have to select it and add the attribute. Now number of attribute will be, column will be here 7. So here next one attribute name is over here postal code. So these are the attribute of the relation. What we did it over here till now, we see that the name of entity type become the name of relation, simple and single value attribute of the relation become the attribute of the entity type become the attribute of the relation, identifier of entity type become the primary key. Now then we see that if we have a composite attribute in the relation, simple and meaningful component of the composite attribute become the attribute of the relation. Now if we have a multi-value attribute, like taking the example, attribute may have more than one value, like in the same attribute, in the same entity type customer, we have customer ID, customer name, date of birth, customer address, that is a composite attribute, postal code, single value attribute, customer phone is a multi-value attribute. So whenever we have a multi-value attribute, then how we can deal it? For the multi-value attribute, the rule is that one, if we have a multi-value attribute, for multi-value attribute, we have to create the two relations. First relation contain all of the attribute of the entity type except the multi-value attribute. And the second relation contain the primary key of the first relation and multi-value attribute. So when we see that we are having the entity type that containing a multi-value attribute, we have to create the two relation. First one containing all the other attribute except the multi-value attribute. So we already created for first relation other than the multi-value attribute containing the customer ID, customer name, date of birth, street, city and state and postal code. This one is the first relation, and the second relation will contain the primary key of the first relation, that is the customer ID and multi-value attribute. So let's create the new relation over here. Again we have to select our table, our table are already here, drag and drop it. Now again number of rows we need it over here, just one row, and number of columns here, we see that primary key of the first relation and multivariate attribute. So primary key of the first relation is the customer ID, and the multivariate attribute we see that customer phone. So when we say that customer phone is a multivariate attribute, so attribute of the new relation will be customer ID and customer phone. So what will be, we have to we need the just two column over here in one row. So select the two columns. Now primary key of the first relation is customer ID, and next one we have a multivariate attribute, that is the phone. Now primary key of the first relation is used here as a foreign key. So we see that customer ID is used here as a foreign key. So how we can assign the foreign key? Just we see that we have to create the relations. Just click it over here on this one relation. Now here when we move it over here mouse, it display the red circle over here, small red circle on the attribute. Now drag it and then drop it to the primary key of the main first relation, that is the customer ID. So here customer ID is used, it's mean that customer ID is used as a foreign key. Now as we don't have any other symbol here in Lucid Chart, then we have to use it over here, the word FK within the parentheses or curly braces. I have to use it over here, FK, that is, it's mean that is a foreign key. Now what should be the primary key of the new relation? Primary key of the new relation is the primary key of the first relation, which is used as a foreign key, and multi-value attribute combinedly used as a primary key of the new relation. So customer ID, this one, and phone, underline it, both will be used as a primary key of the new relation. What we have to assign the name of this one new relation, then again insert documents, drag and drop it over here. Now mention here custom phone, and this way we may be able to transform the regular entry type, simple composite, simple and single value attribute, composite attribute and multivariate attribute into the relation. Now in next steps we may be able to write the query for these in SQL using the create table statement. In create table statement, we have to mention first create the customer table, mention all the attribute and their data type, then we have to create the customer phone. In customer phone we have to mention the customer ID and phone, mention the data type and combine them as a primary key. That is the way. And next video we will discuss how to transform weak entry type into the relation. Thanks for watching the video.